Implicit solutions, level 2. In this video, we're going to illustrate how to verify implicit solutions to ordinary differential equations, as well as finding explicit solutions and defining appropriate intervals of definition. Let's go ahead and jump straight into the first example. Verify that the indicated function is an implicit solution to the differential equation. If possible, find an explicit solution. Give an interval I of definition for each explicit solution. The differential equation is y prime equals x over y. The implicit solution to verify is y squared equals x squared minus 3. Alright, let's first verify this implicit solution. Let's start by taking the derivative of this function implicitly with respect to x. Carrying out the differentiation and applying the chain rule, along with the power rule, we obtain the following expression. Next is just a matter of solving for the derivative, in this case, y prime. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Simplifying the expression, we see that the derivative is equal to x over y. The next step is to verify that the left-hand side of the differential equation equals the right-hand side. So we go ahead and substitute this expression into the differential equation as follows. Notice that both sides of the equation match. This means that the implicit solution is indeed a solution to the differential equation. Now let's determine an appropriate interval of definition. Let's start by plotting this function. Recall that an equation of this form describes a hyperbola that opens along the x-axis and is centered at the origin. Inspecting the graph, we see that the derivative would not be defined at the vertices, because the slope of the tangent line at these points is vertical, and therefore undefined, meaning that we need to exclude these points from the interval of definition. Next, let's check and see if we can find an explicit solution by solving for the variable y, and obtaining an expression in terms of x. Looking at the implicit solution, we see that solving for the variable y is fairly straightforward. It's just a matter of taking the square root of both sides of the expression. Doing that, we obtain the following. Y equals positive negative the square root of x squared minus 3. Here we have two explicit solutions. One represents the upper, and the other represents the lower half of the hyperbola. Notice that the domain of each explicit solution is defined by the inequality the absolute value of x is greater than or equal than the square root of 3. However, because this implicit function is not differentiable at the vertices, we need to exclude these values from the domain so that we can define an appropriate interval of definition. If we were to use the positive explicit solution, our interval of definition would be defined from negative infinity to negative square root of 3, exclusive, or from the interval positive square root of 3, exclusive, to positive infinity. If we were to use the negative explicit solution, we would have the same interval of definition, but this time, we would be using the bottom half of the hyperbola. In this example, we were able to find an explicit solution and use it to define an appropriate interval of definition. Keep in mind that this would not always be the case. It might just be impossible to find an explicit solution from the implicit relation. Alright, let's try the next example. The differential equation is y prime equals the quantity y minus 1 times the quantity 1 minus 2y. And the implicit solution to verify is the natural log of the quantity 2y minus 1 divided by the quantity y minus 1 equals x. Alright, let's first verify this implicit solution. We first need to find the derivative of this implicit relation. Before we proceed with the implicit differentiation step, let's first rewrite this expression in a more derivative-friendly form. Let's apply the laws or rules of logarithms that you learned in your Algebra 2 class. We're going to break apart the natural logarithm into a difference of logarithms, as follows. Now that we have the implicit function in this form, let's go ahead and take the derivative implicitly with respect to x. Carrying out the derivative and applying the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, we need to solve for the first derivative, in this case, y prime. So we go ahead and factor out this term as follows. Next, let's go ahead and add the fractions by finding a common denominator. and rewriting the numerators accordingly. Next, let's simplify the terms in the numerator. And finally, let's multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of the expression inside the brackets. Doing this, we obtain the following expression for the derivative. After that, let's substitute this expression into the differential equation and verify that both the left and right-hand side of the equation match. Substituting the expression into the equation and simplifying the left-hand side of the equation, we see that both sides coincide. This means that this implicit function is indeed a solution to the differential equation. Now let's determine an appropriate interval of definition. The implicit relation is not a conic section, or an implicit function that you have encountered in your studies of mathematics. So let's first see if we can find an explicit solution. Going back to the implicit solution, let's try to solve for y in terms of x. We can achieve this by first exponentiating both sides of the equation, and using the number e as our base. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, let's multiply both sides of the equation by the quantity y minus 1. After that, we need to distribute the exponential term into the quantity y minus 1 as follows. From here, we need to move all the terms that contain the variable y into one side of the equation and the rest of the terms to the other side of the equation. Moving all the terms with the variable y to the left and the rest to the right side of the equation, we obtain the following expression. At this point, it's just a matter of factoring out the variable y from the left-hand side of the equation. Then we solve for the variable y by dividing both sides by the quantity 2 minus e raised to the power of x. Doing that, we obtain the following explicit solution. So we were lucky that we actually found an explicit solution to the differential equation. Now let's take a look at the graph of this explicit solution. Notice that this graph is not defined at x equals the natural log of 2. So we would expect to see a vertical asymptote at this given value of x. As a result, the graph would be split into two regions, which translates into two distinct intervals of definition to choose from. One interval of definition is from negative infinity to the natural log of 2 exclusive, and the second interval is from the natural log of 2 exclusive to positive infinity. Either of these two intervals are appropriate intervals of definition. Alright, in our next video, we will continue verifying implicit solutions to differential equations and go over slightly more challenging examples.